ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्याज्ञानञ्जनशलाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशकौपतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितनां पवानेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे. So we're going to begin the second part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. It's entitled The Glories of Goloka.
我们从今天开始来讲述大伯加尔堂甘露的第二部分，标题为《Goloka的荣耀》.
So the first chapter is entitled Renunciation.
第一章标题是弃绝.
So the chapter begins Janmanjaya. Janmanjaya is speaking.
现在是Janmanjaya开始讲话了。Janmanjaya
is the son of Maharaj Pariksit.
Janmanjaya is Pariksit Maharaj的儿子.
So he's speaking. He says that my father, he gave the essential meaning of the scriptures. He spoke the essential meaning of the scripture, or he understood the essential, the essence of the scriptures.
Janmanjaya 说道, 我的父亲明白经典的核心要义.
And because of his great love for Krishna, he was able to show to his mother the confidential truth of love of Krishna.
由于对Krishna的这份巨大的爱, 他可以向,
his mother,
向他的母亲展示对Krishna的爱的这份机密体旨.
Remember his mother, Maharaj Pariksit's mother was Uttara, and Uttara had approached Maharaj Pariksit, and she'd asked Maharaj Pariksit to tell her what was the essence of what Sukadeva Goswami had told him.
现在是Pariksit Maharaj的母亲Uttara在接近他的儿子，请求他的儿子给他描述他自己的guru Sukadeva Goswami给他讲述的所谓这些体旨的核心。So
the second part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita begins with Sanatana Goswami offering his respects to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
大伯加尔堂甘露第二部分的开始部分是Sanatana Goswami向Chaitanya Mahaprabhu致以前进的顶拜.
Sanatana Goswami is a direct disciple of Lord Chaitanya.
Sanatana Goswami 是主Chaitanya的直系门徒.
So he says, by taking shelter of Lord Chaitanya, even a dull person like me can be inspired to dance wonderfully.
Sanatana Goswami 说道，通过托庇于Chaitanya Mahaprabhu，甚至像我这样一个直女人。
So the second half of this Brihad Bhagavatamrita is going to tell us about the glories of the spiritual planet Goloka.
大伯加尔堂甘露的第二部分将要告诉我们 Goloka 这个灵性星球的荣耀.
And it's in Goloka where the pure devotees get the essence of Lord Krishna's mercy.
正是在 Goloka 这个地方，纯粹的奉献者获得了圣主 Krishna 的仁慈的精髓。
And they enjoy the ecstasy of playing with Krishna forever there.
他们在那里享受着和圣主 Krishna 永恒的玩耍的狂喜。
So to prepare us for hearing about Goloka, which is Krishna's abode, we first have to hear about other places in the material and spiritual world.
为了让我们做好准备来聆听主 Krishna 的亲身居所 Goloka 的荣耀，首先我们要聆听其他的地方。物质世界和灵性世界其他地方的这个情况。
Yeah. So we heard the first part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita about Narada Muni searching for the people who got the greatest mercy from Krishna.
我们已经聆听了大伯教兰把谈甘露第一部分的内容，讲述的是拿的母女在寻找那些人得到了主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。
嗯，嗯，所以 the first chapters began with a story.In answer to a question by Uttara.
为了回答 Uttara 的询问，这个第一章呢就讲述了一个故事。
To answer the question put by Uttara.
这个是由这个故事来回答 Uttara 提出的问题。
And it told us that.We were able to understand something of the glories of devotional service here on this earth planet.
就是为了告诉我们，通过这个故事可以理解，在这个地球星球做奉献服务的荣耀。
We heard about worship offered to Krishna by a learned devotee.
我们听到。对圣主 Krishna 所做出的崇拜，而这些崇拜呢，是由博学的奉献者做出的。
He was a Brahmana and he was the master of a village.
他是一位婆罗门，也是一个村庄的主人。
And then we heard about a mighty king.
随后我们听到了一位强有力的国王。
So, to hear more about the conversation which took place between Uttara and Maharaj Parikshit, Janmanjaya, his son, is asking a question.
为了深入理解 Uttara 和 Parikshit Maharaj 之间的对话，
So Janmanjaya asks his guru. His guru's name is Jaimini.
Janmanjaya 就问了他的 guru Jaimini 一个问题。
So to please his guru, Janmanjaya.When he speaks about what he has heard so far, what he's been hearing so far.
为了取悦自己的 guru, Janmanjaya 就讲述了他迄今为止所听到的内容。
So, Maharaj, in the first part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, we heard about.How Maharaj Parikshit spoke.
我们在大伯教堂甘露的第一部分已经听到了 Parikshit 大君所讲述的话语。
And he told his mother what was the essence of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
他告诉自己的母亲圣典摩迦瓦坛的精华。
It's the Bhagavatam which is the best of all the scriptures.
摩迦瓦坛是所有精华的所有经典当中的佼佼者。
So to do that, he had to understand many scriptures.
所以为了能够得到这一结论，他必须首先要理解许多的经典。
And he had to have knowledge from many different sources.
他也必须从许多的源头那里聆听过各种知识。
And he had to understand what was the real purport behind these teachings.
他也必须要理解在所有这些教导背后的目的。
Because they are teaching confidential devotional service to the Supreme Lord.
因为他们教授的是对至尊主的至尊主的奉爱服务。
All right, so Janmanjaya accepts everything which he had heard in this first part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. He accepts it all as being the truth.
Janmanjaya.
Go ahead.
Janmanjaya 就接受他在大宝教坛甘露的第一部分所聆听到的一切，他把他们都接受为是真理。
So Janmanjaya says, he said, I cannot drink enough of the nectarian ocean of Srimad Bhagavatam.
他说道，我聆听这部大宝教，我把博加瓦坛甘露，这个甘露的海洋，我畅饮还觉得不够。
And it's the fragrance, the aroma coming from this Srimad Bhagavatam is increased because it's coming from your lotus mouth.
由于它是出自您的莲花口，所以圣典薄伽瓦坛所散发出的芬芳便弥漫了整个世界。
So, this son of Maharaj Parikshit, Janmanjaya, he has already tasted this nectar in the first part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, but he wants to taste more.
Parikshit 大君的儿子 Janmanjaya 已经品尝了大薄伽瓦坛第一部分的甘露，但是他现在想要品尝更多甘露。
It's a Bhagavatam which reveals the secrets of pure devotional service.
正是圣典薄伽瓦坛这部经典揭示了纯粹的奉爱服务的奥秘。
And the Bhagavatam is full of beauty and great wealth.
圣典薄伽瓦坛充满了美丽和巨大的财富。
So these scriptures like Srimad Bhagavatam are like an ocean.
圣典薄伽瓦坛这样的经典就如浩瀚的海洋。
Just like the ocean is very vast, it's very huge, so this knowledge of the scriptures is very huge, very vast.
正如海洋是宽广的，所以经典也同样是宽广的。
Not only in their size, but also in their ideas.
这不仅仅是指他们的尺寸是宽广的，而且是指的他们的理念是宽广的。
So just like the ocean of milk is the greatest ocean, Srimad Bhagavatam is the greatest devotional scripture.
正如牛乃之羊是最了不起的海洋，圣典摩加瓦坛是最了不起的经典。
So Narada had been searching for the person who got the greatest mercy from Krishna.
Narada 一直在寻找哪些人从主 Krishna 那里得到最大的仁慈。
So Janmanjaya had heard this story with great taste. He enjoyed taking great pleasure hearing that.
Janmanjaya 他一直在津津有味地品尝着这甘露，这故事的甘露。
But he hasn't heard enough. He wants to hear more.
但是他还是不满足，他想要聆听更多的内容。
So his guru Jaimini, he had been giving him the nectar, and he had put.His own, from his own speaking, his own lotus mouth, he'd increased that nectar. He'd made it more, even more enjoyable.
Jaimini, 已经讲。
Jaimini's guru.Jaimini's guru, Jaimini is a guru, Janmanjaya's guru, Jaimini, he had made the message even more enjoyable.
Janmanjaya 的 guru, Jaimini, 就使得由于他自己莲花口所吐露出的这些讯息呢，就使得这份甘露呢更加乐于被人乐于品尝。
So, Janmanjaya, he cannot hear enough. He wants to hear more.
因此 ，Janmanjaya 呢，就觉得还不满足，他渴望聆听更多的甘露。
So he asks, "Please tell me what other topics were discussed by the mother Uttara and the son Parikshit."
所以他便询问说，请告诉我，在乌特拉和 Parikshit 大军之间还进行了哪些其他的讨论？
We know they were also greedy to enjoy the taste of Krishna's lotus feet.
我们知道他们都渴望，贪婪的渴望 Krishna 的莲花足。
So,We should understand the things which were discussed between Uttara, the mother, and Parikshit, the son, that they were very special, it was very special knowledge meant only for pure devotees.
要知道在 Uttara 以及 Parikshit 大军这对母子之间所进行的讨论，他们讨论的题旨呢是针对那些是特殊的知识，是纯粹的奉献者，他们品尝的知识。
But the guru Jaimini is the guru of Janmanjaya. He is qualified. He was qualified to hear and to understand.
Janmanjaya 的 guru Jaimini 身具资格。他是有资格来理解、聆听这门知识。
So the guru Jaimini, he says to Janmanjaya, he tells him, he said, to understand or speak about these things by our own strength is impossible.
Jaimini 便对他的门徒说道，要明白以及靠我们自己的力量去明白或者是讲述这个题旨是不可能的。
Even great sages who know the absolute truth find them difficult to understand.
即便是已经了解了绝对真理的伟大圣人们，也难以理解。
So we should understand from this that the essence of devotional service is beyond the power of words to explain.
从这一点，我们可以理解到，奉献服务的本质，是超越了言语的范畴。
And it's beyond the power of the mind to understand.
它也超越了心意的范畴，心意是无法理解的。
And even the mystic yogis who can see the past and the present and the future, and even liberated souls find it difficult to understand.
即便是已经了解了过去、现在。以及未来的玄秘瑜伽师们，或者是那些解脱了的灵魂们，都发现很难理解这一体旨。
This knowledge is far beyond the knowledge of the impersonal Brahman.
这门知识远远超越于非人格。基础之上。
This knowledge is shared by Lord Krishna and his pure devotees.
这门知识是由主 Krishna 和他纯粹奉献者相互理解的。
So Janmanjaya says that Srila Vyasadeva, Sukadeva Goswami.Is an ocean of rasa of Krishna.
Sukadeva Goswami 是有关于 Krishna 的这个海洋的 rasa.
And Jaimini says, by his mercy, I sat next to him. I sat near Parikshit and Uttara.And I heard that conversation.
他说，其实 Krishna Jaimini 说，其实圣主 Krishna 的仁慈，我得以坐在 Uttara 和 Parikshit 这对母子身旁，从而聆听到他们的对话。
Yeah, right. So Jaimini is saying that Krishna.And his devotional service are beyond the mind and words.
Jaimini 说 ，Krishna 及对 Krishna 的奉爱服务是超越了心意、超越了言语的范畴。
So we will wonder then, how was Jaimini able to speak the first part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita?
我们可能就会提出疑惑，既然如此，展密尼又如何能够讲述大伯加瓦坛的第一部分的内容呢？
So Jaimini says that Sukadeva Goswami empowered him.
展密尼回答， Sukadeva Goswami 已经给予他，已经赋予了他力量。
Jaimini was expert in different kinds of Vedic knowledge.
Jaimini 擅长于伟达知识的各个分支。
And he had realization of the absolute truth.
他已经觉悟到了绝对的真理。
But he was not able to understand or describe Krishna's glories.
但是他还没有明白，以及他也不能形容 Krishna 的荣耀。
Not by he couldn't do it by just simply by his own qualification.
他不能仅仅凭着他自己的资格来做到这一点。
But when he became empowered by the exalted Vaishnavas like Sukadev, then he could do it.
只有当他被像 Shukadev 这样的崇高的 Vaishnava 赋予了力量之后，他才可以完成。
Actually, Jaimini was the only person qualified to repeat what had been discussed between Uttara and Parikshit.
事实上 ，Jaimini 是唯一一位能够重复 Uttara 和 Parikshit 二者对话的人选。
So Sukadeva Goswami he arranged for Jaimini to sit in a place.Next to them, so that he could hear their conversation.
Shukadev Goswami 就安排 Jaimini 坐在 Uttara 和 Parikshit 这对母子的讨论的地方的附近，好让他聆听到他们的对话。
And this way, Shukadeva Goswami.Was empowered. He was also empowered by Sukadeva Goswami. Jaimini was empowered by Sukadeva Goswami.
这样一来 ，Jaimini 就被 Sukadeva Goswami 授予了力量。
And he could properly understand what they were talking about.
这样一来，他就可以正确的理解这对母子的谈话内容。
And it's only by the mercy of great devotees like Sukadeva Goswami that we can hear this Brihad Bhagavatamrita.
正是由于 Shukadev Goswami 这位伟大奉献者的仁慈，我们今天才能够聆听到大伯教化堂甘露。
So the Vedas say that you may speak the most confidential secret to a very loyal disciple.
韦达经说道，你可以。像一位忠实的门徒，传授最机密的体旨。
So, we're told we have to prepare ourselves to hear the glories of Goloka.
我们被告知要做好准备，聆听 Goloka 的荣耀。
And we should consider ourselves very fortunate.
我们应该认为自己是非常走运的。
So, this is very confidential knowledge.
这是一门机密的体旨。
But Jaimini is willing to speak because he considers his disciple qualified to hear.
Jaimini 仍然准备开口讲述这机密的体旨，因为他认为自己的门徒已经有资格来聆听。
Yeah, in the first part of the book, we heard about the glories of the different devotees of Krishna.
在这本书的第一部分，我们已经聆听到了圣主 Krishna 不同奉献者的荣耀了。
Now we're going to hear about the glories of Goloka.The place which is dearest to Lord Krishna.
现在我们将要聆听 Goloka 的荣耀。Goloka 是对圣主 Krishna, 圣主 Krishna 非常钟爱的地方。
So this description will help us to understand the glory of Krishna and his devotees.
这将能够帮助我们理解。Krishna, 即奉献者的荣耀。
So the Jaimini says to the disciple, he says, after your grandmother heard this conversation about the search for the person most favored by the mercy of Krishna. She was filled with bliss.
Jaimini 对他的门徒说道，当你的祖母聆听了这个对话，他的描述是他在描述哪的母女在寻找哪些人是得到了主 Krishna 仁慈的青睐。这时候你的祖母呢内心充满了极乐。
So Janmanjaya is the son of Parikshit, and Parikshit is the son of Uttara. So Uttara is the grandmother.
Janmanjaya is Parikshit's son. Parikshit is also Uttara's son. So Uttara is Janmanjaya's mother.
So we're hearing.We're hearing what Janmanjaya heard from his guru, Jaimini.
We're now listening to Janmanjaya from his guru, Jaimini, from his mouth.
So Lord Krishna has a special fruit which he gives to his very pure devotees.
主 Krishna 给他的纯粹奉献者一种特殊的水果。
And Uttara was eager to hear about that fruit.
Uttara 非常渴望能聆听到这个水果果实。
And she wanted to hear about the place where people enjoy that fruit.
她也渴望聆听，这个地点，就在这个地点，人们在津津有味地品尝着这个果实。
And she could understand this place is even higher than Vaikuntha.
她也能够明白，这个地点呢，甚至高于胜过了百昆塔。
So Uttara was thinking about these things in her heart.
这便是 Uttara 的内心的想法。
But she was not able to understand everything, so she inquired about it from her son, Parikshit.
但是呢，她还不能明白一切，因此呢，她便询问自己的儿子 Parikshit。
So Mother Uttara was not certain about the identity of the place of Lord Krishna's pastimes.
Uttara 母亲呢，她不能肯定，Krishna 上演逍遥时光的这个地点到底是在哪个地方。
She thought.This place where Krishna is having his pastime, very intimate pastimes, must be greater than any other place in the kingdom of God.
他认为主 Krishna 上演最亲密的逍遥时光的地点呢，一定要比神的。其他的神的国度都要伟大。
You know, the kingdom of God is, usually we think Vaikuntha, that's the spiritual world. But this place is above Vaikuntha.
通常呢，人们会认为，神的王国呢，指的是Vaikuntha，灵性世界。然而这个地点呢，甚至它超越了，高于Vaikuntha。
So she understood that her son, Parikshit, that he was qualified to be able to help her to understand this place.
母亲 Uttara 确信她的儿子有资格帮助她理解这个地方。
So she's asking her son to please explain about this place to her.
所以他就请求自己的儿子，嗯，请你，请他向他自己来解释这一地点。
So we'll stop here and we'll ask for some questions.
好，那我们的正课部分就讲到这里，接下来我们来回答问题。好，顶拜 Guru， 顶拜所有奉献者。怎么理解履行好自己的职责比完美的履行别人的职责强这句话？例如，我替别人干活，这个人是防火责任人，每天都有在房间里抽烟的小孩，我可以告诉上级管理吗？obeisance to Guru and all devotees, how to understand it's far better to carry out our own duty than to carry out the duties of others. For example, the other's job is to take care of there's no fire around. But every day there are children who is smoking in the room. Can I complain this to the leader? In that case, I'm doing the duty of others.
Well, yes, you can complain to your leader. That's a proper authority. Go through the authority channel. If he's the authority, then complain to him.
就是您可以就是按照这个管理架构啊，就向领导来告诉上级领导，如果这个责任防火人呢就是您的领导，您就可以直接告诉他。
Certainly, people smoking, there's a risk of fire. So many places now, they will have a special room, only one room where they can smoke.
安排抽烟的人都在这个房间里抽烟。The next one is Shruti Rupa Devadasi 说，顶拜 Guru 和顶拜 Guru 老师，请问《博伽梵歌》中教导的要与众生为友，是否即便我们遇到无神论者和不喜欢的人，也要训练自己，把他们当作神的孩子来尊敬和礼貌相待呢？感恩。So in obeisance to Guru, in Bhagavad Gita, it is said we shall be very friendly to all living entities. Does that mean that when we meet with the atheists and those we don't like, we shall train ourselves and to respect them and to be polite to them, to take them as the children of God? Thank you.
Yes, Krishna is also in the heart of the atheist and people who have no faith and no belief. Krishna is also in their heart. So we should be a little kind to them. At the same time, we're careful not to get too friendly with them.
Krishna 呢，也在这些无神论者还有没有信仰的人们心中，我们应该对他们友善，但是呢，与此同时，我们要小心不要跟他们过于亲密。
Yes. don't eat the food cooked by them.
不要吃他们做的食物。
Don't have intimate association with them.
不要跟他们有亲密的联谊。
嗯，还有问题吗？
还有，嗯 ，Yuvati Sachi Devadasi Hare Krishna, dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. We are very new devotees, so sometimes we need Vapu, not just the Vani of spiritual master. That is, we are supported.Not only by the instructions of the guru, but also by his darshan and personal communication. The first question, is this statement true for our level? Yuvati Sachi 的问题是，嗯 ，Hare Krishna， 姑妈，我们是非常新的奉献者，有的时候我们需要亲身的联谊，而不仅仅是灵应导师的训示。这就是说我们不仅仅是被咕噜的训示所支撑着，而且还是通过能够见到咕噜，能跟咕噜有亲身的交流，能得到支持。这第一个问题，这句话对于我们这个层面的人来说是不是对的吗？
Not really. This associationAccording to scripture, association can be there, but it can be very, very short. They say lava matra, one moment of a second. So that it's not that association with the, you have to be there with them all the time and you have to be close with, it's not like that. You can simply hear the guru, you come to hear. That's the real business and association with the guru.
这句话就是不尽然，因为就是
lava matra
就是指的是一秒钟的哪怕是片刻的时间，就是并不是说一直要在咕噜旁边跟咕噜特别的近乎，应该是聆听咕噜，来聆听咕噜，这才是跟咕噜联谊的真正的事物。除此之外还有经典， you said there is also sutra, right?
I said what?
The scripture is,
Did I? Anyway, you have to understand association with the spiritual teacher is more by hearing.
所以您应该明白呢，就是跟灵性导师的联谊呢，是指的是通过聆听来跟灵性导师联谊。
Physical association.You don't need too much.
至于这个亲身的联谊呢，是不需要大量那种亲身的联谊。
Srila Prabhupada said he only got association with his spiritual teacher 4 or 5 times.
圣帕帕德说，他和他自己的灵性导师的亲身联谊呢，只有4-5次。
But he said there were other people who were with the spiritual teacher a lot, but after he departed, they did not stay faithful in service.
而其他的门徒呢，和他们自己的咕噜呢，有很多的亲身联谊。一旦咕噜离开之后呢，他们就没有忠心耿耿的在这继续做着服务了。
So we see, just like mosquitoes, they associate, they may sit on the body of the guru, but their business is just to bite and suck the blood.
比如说蚊子，蚊子呢，它也是跟孤儿的联谊很亲密呢，它就在孤儿的身上，但是它呢，蚊子呢，它就是来叮咬这个孤儿，来吸孤儿的血的。
So association is not so much physical presence, but it's more through sound vibration.
因此联谊呢，并不是指的就是亲身的临在，是指的是联谊的含义。联谊呢，是指的更多的含义是指的这个音阵，通过音阵来联谊。The second part, should we avoid attachment to the personality of theGuru and attach only to his instructions. 第二个问题，我们是不是应该避免依附 Guru 这个人物，只依附于 Guru 的训示呢？
Yes, the instructions are more important. The instructions are eternal.
是的。孤儿的训示是更加重要的，而且孤儿的训示是永恒的训示。
The body of the spiritual teacher is not eternal.
灵性老师的身体不是永恒的。
So if you become attached to that physical form of the spiritual teacher, that won't be very good for your spiritual advancement.
所以呢，变得依附于灵性导师的，身体的形象、身形，这不是好的。对于灵性进步呢，不是好的。
At the same time, it's a duty of the disciple to try to serve the physical to try to serve the physical form of the spiritual teacher.
但是门徒有责任来服务灵性导师的身体，是有责任的。
Spiritual master has a physical body. He has to eat. He has to sleep. So you have to help him to facilitate. You have to give him proper facility to maintain his body.
灵性导师，也要吃饭睡觉，所以门徒呢需要帮助灵性导师，协助灵导师，给灵导师提供设施来维持身体。
And at the same time, you have to also help the spiritual teacher to preach Krishna consciousness.
门徒同时也要帮助灵性导师传播 Krishna 知觉。
By bringing people, by bringing interested people to Krishna consciousness to meet the spiritual teacher, that's a very nice service to do.
通过把对 Krishna 知觉感兴趣的人们，让他们来。见灵性导师，这是对灵性导师的服务。
Yes.
第三个问题 ，Is it right if a disciple does not seek to communicate with his spiritual master at all, considering that these are sentiments, and he should only accept his instructions? 第三个问题。倘若一位门徒根本就不想跟灵性导师沟通交流，认为这些是感情用事， 他认为呢，只应该接受灵性导师的训示，这种观点对吗
？Well, you should be careful about that. You want to have. Sometimes the spiritual teacher likes to know about the disciples, what they're doing, what their service is. Particularly if you're a full-time devotee, you're staying in the Krishna conscious community, maybe you're residing in a temple, and you should say what service you're doing, what particular activities you're taking part in.
尤其是全职的奉献者，或者是居住在 Krishna 知觉的社团当中，或者是居住在庙宇，他应该告知灵性导师他的服务，他参与的活动是什么。
So you don't want to get too far away from the spirit. You don't want to get too close, and you don't want to get too far away.
所以呢，你一方面呢，就是不能跟领导是过于的亲昵，同时呢，也不应该跟领导是，距离过于遥远。
So you have to develop the balance. You have to know how to associate with the spiritual teacher.
所以呢，要掌握好平衡，要知道该怎样和灵性导师联谊。下一个问题是来自于聆听的小鱼儿，请问 Guru， 身边有奉献者是 Krishna 的仁慈的体现吗？This question is that Guru, if there is devotee around me, is it the exhibition of the mercy of Krishna?
If there's devotee around you, is it the mercy of Krishna?
Yes.
Yes, well, you could say.
身边有奉献者。
Yes, that's Krishna's mercy. Krishna's giving you association. We should think we're very fortunate. By the mercy of Krishna, you have association with devotees.
是的，如果有奉献者的联谊，这是幸运的。应该这样想，由于 Krishna 的仁慈呢，我得到了奉献者的联谊。下一个问题，君伟他是哦不，下一个真诚相待。请问 Guru， 自己不纯净就做心意供奉，那达不到标准。达不到标准，要不要去脱壁呢？就去做心意供，如果一直做不到纯粹，就坚持服务，直到躯体离开，也不要脱壁。就不要去脱壁。The question is that, this devotee is asking that, Guru, I'm not pure. If one is not pure and one is doing the offering through mine, if one cannot...attain the level of purity, What about taking shelter? If one cannot become pure and one insists on doing service and until the final moment,
Halibur，这位那个举手吧，然后让他说一下。
好好，那您再澄清一下或者举手。我们先回答下一个问题。桑提，中拉玛显现日，玛雅普戒时到中午，外甥那日历说戒时到日落，遵守哪一个 ？On the appearance of Lord Rama, in Mayapur they fast until noon.But on Vaishnava calendar, it says fast until sunset. Which one shall we follow?
Well, which one do you want to follow?
您那关键是您想要遵守哪个？
There are two days like Gaur Purnima.And Krishna Janmashtami, the appearance of Lord Chaitanya and the appearance of Krishna, they are full day fasting.
有两个日子，在一个是 Gaur Purnima， 就是主 Chaitanya 的显现日，还有一个日子是 Krishna 的显现日 ，Krishna Janmashtami。这两天呢要全戒，必须全戒。
Right, and for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we do fasting until the moonrise.
在主 Chaitanya 的显现日这天呢，是戒时到月亮升起。
And for Krishna Janmashtami, we fast until midnight.
而在 Krishna 显现日这天呢，是要戒时到，半夜十二点。
But other festivals, it's up to you to decide. Some temples they will fast until.The evening, and some temples they will break fast in the midday.
除此之外的其他的节日呢，是因人而异，取决于您个人。有的庙宇呢会戒时到傍晚，而有的庙宇呢会戒时到中午。
So you can decide.
这样呢就是您自己来决定。
OK。
下一个问题 ,211518, 顶拜咕噜，请问人死亡时对于墓地是必须要购买的吗？还是在家供奉祖先的灵位就可以？家人过世了要求买环境好的墓地安放骨灰。Obeisance to Guru, my question that is it necessary if one's relative passed away and we buy a or is it okay that we only have a place?In the altar, have a place that we can make offering to our ancestor at home. Because my relative passed away, and the relatives require that we buy a very nice tomb in a nice environment for them to place the ashes.
Well, that's not our Krishna conscious program. We don't do that as devotees.
这个不是 Krishna 知觉的活动，作为奉献者呢，是不这么做的。
We like to put the ashes into the into the sea or into the holy water like the Ganga.
我们喜欢把骨灰呢撒到海里，或者是放到像恒河这样的圣河里。
They say by putting the ashes into the water of the Ganges, then it gets us free from sinful reactions.
据说把骨灰撒在放在恒河里，就能使这个人能够免除罪恶反应，罪恶的反应。
So this is some other culture. This is your Chinese culture.To put the ashes in a tomb.
把骨灰放在墓地里是中国的文化。
So you have to decide with your relatives.
那么对于您亲戚的这个要求呢，您就自己来决定，自行决定。
Now, if everybody is to put their ashes in a tomb, you have tombs everywhere. The whole country will be full of tombs.
如果每个人死后都把骨灰埋在墓地里，那咱们整个国家呢，到处都是坟了，坟。
How long can you keep the tomb?How long can we have tombs everywhere?
那么这个墓地呢，你能留多久呢？那到遍地都是墓地这种情况，能维持多久呢？
Okay.
下一个是来自 Vivo 23，顶拜 Guru， 老师好。吃了不是纯粹奉献者做的食物，会堕落和更污染，是吗？我有时候不方便在外面吃了食物就不太舒服，第二天念诵就呕吐了，感恩咕噜。So should this devotee pay obeisance to Guru? And the question is that, whether it is true or not that, when we eat food made by those.Devotees who are not pure. When we eat food that's made not by pure devotee, and one will fall down and become more polluted. Sometimes it's not convenient for me, and I will eat food outside. I feel uncomfortable, and the next morning when I chant, I will vomit.
Yes. Well, you should be very careful.Where you eat and what you eat and who you should be careful about eating food from outside. It's very easy to get sick and to get contamination by eating food cooked by non-devotees.
So,
you
should be careful. You should be careful about eating food from outside. And eating food cooked by non-devotees.就要小心，不然的话很容易生病，很容易受到污染。所以呀，不要吃非奉献者做的食物。The next one.
Yeah.
Keshala Priya Hare Krishna， 顶拜见的 Guru Mahar， 买所有奉献者有两个问题想请 Guru。Guru Day， 问题一，脑海里。这些过去发生的事情冒出来，这是 Krishna 专门做出的安排吗？ The first question from Keshava Priya that obeisance to Guru and all devotees. The first question is that my mind are always hovering those things that passed by.Those things are happening already. They are always in my mind. Is it the special arrangement from Krishna?
No.
不是。
It's the arrangement from the modes of nature, from the material energy.
是物质，自然，物质属性的安排，是物质能量的安排。
If you're thinking in terms of your body and your mind, then this is the modes of nature.
如果呢，您的思维呢，都是从心意的角度，从身体的躯体的角度，在考虑事物的话，那么这些都是物自然属性、物自然形态所做出的安排。
So we have to transcend the mind. You have to transcend your bodily consciousness.
所以我们要超越心意，超越躯体的概念。
You listen to your mind, you will always be confused and bewildered and have doubts and illusion.
倘若聆听心意的话呢，一个人就会总是感觉到困惑。迷惘，处在幻象当中。
So, take shelter of the chanting of the holy name, that will cleanse the heart, that will clean, purify the mind.
要脱避于圣名，这将净化心意。第二个问题，对奉献服务中这种品味的贪婪，想要去做更多的服务，更多体验到这种品味，这是感官享乐还是正确的呢 ？So I'm hankering for the taste from devotional service. I want to do more service to relish more from the devotional service. Is itSense gratification, or is it right?
Yeah, it's right. It's sense gratification, but it's pure. It's sense, spiritual sense gratification.
这是正确的，这确实是感官享乐，但这是纯粹的感官享乐，是灵性的感官享乐。
But you have to know your qualification for service.
但是您呢，也要知道认识到自己的服务资格。
We may want to do a lot of service, we may not be qualified to do so much.
我们也许想要做更多的服务，但是我们也许没有资格从事这么多的奉献服务。
And so we have to be humble and we have to do what is appropriate, what is suitable for us, for our level of devotion.
所以我们要谦卑，我们要根据自己的奉献服务的层面去从事正确的服务，合适的、恰当的服务。
So, we have to gradually develop our qualifications. And you have, just like, you know, being a devotee, but you know, we have to practice cooking and learn to become expert in cooking nice dishes for Krishna.
我们要逐步的发展自己的资格，就身为奉献者呢，所以我们要学习做饭，成为烹饪的专家，为 Krishna 做出美味可口的食物。
And we have to cultivate the mood of service to the devotees, pleasing the devotees.
我们要培养服务奉献者的心态，要培养取悦奉献者。
So gradually we can improve, gradually we can do more and more service.
逐渐的呢，我们就能改进提升，逐渐的能从事越来越多的服务了。
Initially, we're not very expert, we're not very qualified, but gradually we can become qualified.
一开始呢，我们可能没有那么擅长，没有那么多的资格，但是逐渐的呢，我们就能变得有资格了。
Okay.
好，下一个来自于 J.S. Das， 感恩精彩的讲解。问题是，享乐是必须有多样性的。问题是，现在在 Kasha Dish 没有庙宇，甚至有的只是一个人，这很容易被物质多样性吸引。该如何做呢？去马普或者创造更多的联谊机会，还是？Thank you for a wonderful lecture. My question that there should be variety if one want to enjoy. But the question is that now in Kasha Dish, there's no temple. Sometimes there's only, in the local province, there's only one devotee. In that case, one is easily attracted by the material variety. So what to do?Whether should we go to Mapu or to create more opportunity to associate?
Well, going to Mayapur, how long can you stay in Mayapur? You can just come and stay in Mayapur forever. You can come to visit Mayapur, but you can't just stay here forever.
那你要去马普的话呢？你能待多久呢？你是不可能永远待在马普的，只能拜访马普，但是不能永远留在那里呀、
啊。So you have to associate. You can associate with devotees by using internet, and sometimes you can go to visit other cities where there are devotees.
您可以通过。网络和奉献者联谊，或者是去拜访有奉献者的地方，从而跟他们联谊。
So you have to think about how to get association in a practical manner. It may be moving to another town, to a city where there's more devotees.
所以您就要想办法怎么才能得到联谊，就是一种实际的方法去得到联谊。比如说可以搬到有更多奉献者居住的这个镇子。
At the same time, of course, it's difficult to just move, to go away and live in another city. It's not so easy thing to do. So you have to associate with people regularly.By internet.
有的时候呢，要搬家也是挺难的一件事儿，也不是那么容易的就能搬家。那在这种情况下呢，可以有定期的网络联谊。
And you have to think how to try to introduce other people to Krishna consciousness.
您还需要，开动脑筋。把 Krishna 之觉介绍给其他的人。
Don't think you're the only devotee there. There must be other devotees there. You just have not found them yet.
不要想着你是当地唯一的奉献者，也许还有别的奉献者呢，只是您还没找到呢。
Okay.
下一个问题 ，vivo 二三，礼拜咕噜戒食滴水不吃，还是戒五谷根豆的感恩？您说的是 ekadasi 吗？obeisance to guru on the fast day. Whether shall we fast even from water or We fast only from grain and beans. Thank you, Guru.
Well, you have to consider what you're able to do. Are you able to fast without water? If you can do it, okay. If you can't, you may be busy, you may be working, you're not able to fast without water, so drink water.
那么这个就取决于您能做到什么呢? 如果您可以戒水,那可以,那就可以戒水。 如果您很忙,还有工作的话,不能不喝水,那您就喝吧。
There are different levels of fasting.
戒食有不同的层面。
Now some people may do full fasting, dry without water, and some people they may take water, and sometimes other people they cannot fast fully, so they will take some fruits.
有一种层面呢，就是，全戒，甚至水也不喝；还有一种层面呢，就是只喝水；还有一种戒食层面呢，是，包括要吃些水果的。
Now, as far as fasting, on the Krishna Janmashtami, the appearance day of Lord Krishna, and on the Gaur Purnima, the appearance day of Lord Chaitanya, those days it must be Ekadasi Prasadam.
就是在 Krishna Janmashtami, Krishna 显现日以及 Gaur Purnima, 就柴丹殿的显现日这两天呢, 是要用 Ekadasi Prasadam 来打破戒食。
And other festivals, like the appearance of Lord Ramachandra, it can be Ekadasi or it may be grains. You can decide for yourself.
而在别的节日, 比如说主Rama的显现日, 可以是用 Ekadasi 餐打破戒食。 或者是用五谷带五谷的餐食打破戒食，这个是由个人决定。In
Mayapur, they have the deity of Lord Nrisingadev. So on the appearance day of Lord Nrisingadev, there will be no grains, and they will fast until the evening.
在马普呢，这里有主 Nrisingadev 的神像，所以在主 Nrisingadev 显现的这一天呢。 他们是一直要戒食到傍晚，而且是，他们打破戒食的这个餐食呢，是也不包括五谷的。But
some temples may do differently. It's up to the temple to decide for themselves.
但是其他的庙宇呢，可能执行方式就不一样了，这是由。
Actually, for all the festivals of Lord Vishnu, different incarnations of Vishnu, it's good to just take Ekadasi Prasadam, if you can.
事实上呢，就是如果可能的话，如果能做到的话呢，在所有Vishnu化身的 节日上呢，最好都是用 Ekadasi 餐来打破戒食，就是如果可以。
But it's not compulsory.
但是这个呢，不是强制性的。You
can decide. Sometimes the temples they say it's not practical to do Ekadasi Prasadam. Like many people are coming. To prepare Ekadasi Prasadam is difficult for some temples.
有的庙宇呢，他们就觉得这个不切实际，因为Ekadasi餐做起来就要难，因为来人呢有很多。But
at least on Gaur Purnima, for the festival of Lord Chaitanya and the festival of Lord Krishna, there must be Ekadasi.
但是在格尔普尼玛和 Krishna 显现日这两个节大节上呢，是必须 用 Egalistan 打破戒石。
But that's for devotees. For people who are not devotees, they can be given grains.
而且这也只是针对奉献者而言的。对于非奉献者而言呢，他们是可以吃五谷的。
Okay.
Okay. Your attitude is thank you very much, dear Mar, for important answers and instructions. Kesha Priya, Devadasi, 第三。从内心由渴求的念诵圣名到服务圣名，这个心态的转变，这个过程感觉失去了和 Krishna 的链接，没有了临在的感觉，怎么样会变得越来越好的服务圣名，再次体验到临在，这个执着是正确的心态吗？So, when I transformed my mentality of chanting from aspire to serve the holy name. During the process, I felt that I lost the connection with Lord Krishna. There is no, I cannot feel his presence. So how can I serve the holy name better and once again experience the presence of the holy name? Is this the right mentality? Is this attachment the right mentality?
Well, yes, you have to feel the presence of Krishna in the holy name. That Lord Krishna is his name. He's not just in the name, but he is his name. There's no difference between Krishna and Krishna's name. But that is very advanced level of chanting.
Krishna就是圣明本身，它跟圣名是没有区别的，但是这是非常进步的层面才能体验到的。
Anyway, the important thing is to keep chanting and try to chant more and try to chant with feeling from the heart.
无论如何，重要的就是要不断的念诵。保持念诵，更多的念诵，又带着感情去念诵，要发自内心的念诵。
嗯哼。
服务资格怎么理解 ？You gotta kishore, that's it. How to understand the qualification for service?
Qualification for service is simply.That humility, humility that we consider ourselves to be very far, very unqualified and unworthy of being allowed to serve, but we want to try.
这个服务的资格是指的谦卑，就我们认为自己是没有资格服务的，是不配做这个服务的。但是呢，我们好歹被允许做这个服务，所以我们就想试一试。
So we pray to Krishna, please engage me in your service.
所以我们向 Krishna 祈祷，请你让我为你做服务吧。
We say to Krishna, please accept me as your servant.
我们对 Krishna 说 ，Krishna， 请你接受我为你的仆人吧。
And please give me the strength to serve you nicely.
请赐予我力量，好让我好好的为你服务。
嗯哼。
下一个问题来自于关景如。 顶拜咕噜念诵十六圈有一段时间了，最近觉得心里有些烦躁，感觉像和外界做斗争，感觉来自外面家人和周围邻居的负能量，感觉他们的嫉妒和对物质的抓取，不想和外界打交道，喜欢一个人独处，如何超脱呢？ So, Guru, I have been chanting 16 rounds for some time. Recently, I felt a little unsteady, worried in the mind. I felt I'm fighting with the outer environment. I felt my feeling is that there are some a negative energy from family members and from neighbors. I felt that they have the envy in their heart and they have the material ambitions. Therefore, I don't want to deal with the outer environment. I only want to stay lonely. How can I transcend this mentality?
Well, we have to develop the proper mood. We shouldn't be, you have to be careful about being critical of others.
如果您要发展正确的心态呢，您就要小心，不要批评别人，只挑剔别人。
Don't look down on other people, but just understand that they have a different, somehow they have a different situation from your situation.
不要瞧不起别人，你要明白呢。不知怎的，别人跟你的处境就是不一样。
You should consider yourself fortunate to have a higher understanding about the goal of life.
你应该觉得自己是鸿运当头，因为您对于生命的目标呢，有了更高的理解了。
So you don't want to make enemies. You do want to keep friendly relationships with other people, even though they may not be devotees.
所以呢，就是您啊，就不要树敌。即便呢，别人不是奉献者，你也希望跟他们保持友好的关系。
Yeah, if you make enemies, then it will become very difficult for your own devotional service.
如果您到处树敌的话，您做奉献服务就难了。
So you must be cautious, be careful how you think of others. Just try to concentrate on improving your own.Meant your own state of mind.
所以你要谨慎，要小心。对别人的观点，你如果看待别人这一点呢，你要小心了。你要专注于提升自己，专注于自己的心态。
Okay.
下一个问题。Vivo Charleston, 顶拜 Guru, 念诵圣名。Guru, 念诵圣名什么时候都可以念，还是要日出升起前，还是什么时间更合适？感恩 Guru 老师。This devotee is asking whether we can chant the holy name any time of the day or before the sunrise, which is the best time?Suitable time for me to chant. Thank you.
Any time is good. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught us there are no rules in this chanting. You can chant any time.
任何时间念诵都是好时间。 没有规则。柴坦尼马哈帕布告诉我们，对于念诵圣名而言，没有硬性规则。
But still, we do recommend, especially a good time, a powerful time to chant, is early morning. There's a period in the morning called Brahma Muhurta, which comes 1.5 hours before sunrise.
但是即便如此呢，仍然推荐就最有力量的时间段呢，是在清晨在日出前的一个半小时，称为 Brahma Muhurta。 这个时间段念诵，这个时间段是最有力量的。
Of course, some parts, like in North China, in the summer, the sun rises very early in the morning. It would be difficult to follow that.
当然，在中国的北部地区呢，夏天的时候太阳出得特别早，所以特别早的起床也是不可能的。
You can chant any time in the day. Generally, though, we do like to chant first thing in the morning. That's good. The mind is more fresh and able to concentrate.
所以任何时间念诵都可以，但是呢，我们一般就是早晨一件事就念诵，这时候呢，心意呢特别的朝气蓬勃，也容易专注。
As the day goes on, then you have to cook meals, you have to go to market, do shopping, and people will call you on your mobile phone. So many issues come which distract you and make it difficult for you to concentrate on chanting.
到了白天呢，你又得做饭，还得去市场上买东西，还要打电话，有这么多分心的事情，这样呢，专注念诵呢就很难了。
Okay.
The last question. 最后一个问题，梁田儿。Hare Krishna, 顶拜亲爱的 Gurudev, 顶拜所有的奉献者，我每天早晚顶拜您的莲花祖，祈祷我的服务能得到您的祝保护，每次得到您的涟漪和感应，内心充满幸福和喜悦。我一直遵循您的教导，念16圈做 Prasadam, 服务帕布，不去冒犯他，但是他现在还是要求我煮鸡蛋给他吃，因此没有资格申请您的启迪，很是困惑，祈求您的教导。So, Hare Krishna, obeisance dear Gurudev and all devotees. So this is like a small letter. Every day, every morning and evening, I pay obeisance to your lotus feet and pray to get your blessing from every service I do and get your protection. And every time I can get, once I get your association, and I have some feeling, and I feel very happy and blissful. I always follow your instruction and chant good 16 rounds, cook nice prasadam, and to serve my Prabhu, don't offend him. But recently, and until now,He insists that I cook eggs for him. Therefore, I don't have the qualification to apply to be your to get initiation from you. I felt bewildered. Therefore, I beg instruction from you.
Well, you have to be patient, and you have to continue serve your Prabhu.You have to try to convince him that you can cook nice food without eggs.
You have to be patient to serve your Prabhu. No matter how you convince him, let him believe you can make him some good eggs without eggs.
There's many other nice foodstuffs to cook besides eggs. You don't need eggs. So you just have to cook very nicely that he doesn't need eggs. And if you're patient in course of time, then your Prabhu will be kind to you. And he'll say he can live without eggs.
您那个要就是舒服您的帕布，还要做好吃的，让您的帕布感觉就是没有鸡蛋也能也可以啊，所以您需要耐心，还需要时间。嗯，您就好好的去好好的做这些食物，让他就不想吃鸡蛋了，那最后呢他就能对您很好，就不要求鸡蛋了。
OK.
So there are two more questions.
OK.
OK. 那么很快看一下两个问题。Madhu Kanta. Panchatava Das, first of all, he says, thank you so much for your mercy, dear Maharaj. Obeisance to you and all devotees, Hare Krishna. Madhu Kanti Das.敬爱的 Gurudev 顶拜您的莲花组，我最近读经典就爱分享，有时也掺杂了自己的思想，用了自己的经验，我可以这样分享吗？ Dear Gurudev, obeisance to your lotus feet. Recently, I like to share the scripture I read, but sometimes I mixed my own idea and I mixed my own experience. Can I shareThe scripture in this way?
Yes, so long as your experience is in line with Krishna conscious philosophy.
嗯，您是可以这样分享的，但是条件就是说，您的体验呢，要跟 Krishna 直觉的哲学是一致的。
嗯。Your experience should help people to understand more the process of Krishna consciousness.
就是您需要去让别人更多的能够明白 Krishna 知觉的哲学。
Yeah, in talking to people and preaching, generally we will talk about our own experiences.
在和别人谈话以及向别人讲道的过程当中，我们确实也会分享自己的体验。
So that's good preaching.
所以您的这个是很好的一个传教。
Provided it helps them to understand better the message of Krishna.
只要能够更好的帮助他们能理解 Krishna 知觉的讯息。
OK, 我们结束了。
OK, 那我们剩下两个问题留到下一个吧。
还有问题。
Yeah, two more.
他们是谁？
子熙，还有良田，他有一个祈求梁田，他说祈求您的祝福，在清晨完整的能念完十六圈。
好，我们祝福你。She just wants blessings.
Yes, she wants blessings that she can.
Okay, that's not a question. We don't read these things if they just want blessing.
Okay. Yeah. But there are two more questions. Shall we keep it next time or continue?
Yeah, it's getting late.
Okay. 那也太晚，时间已经超过九点了。剩下两个问题呢，就我们就保存到下节课再回答。
Okay. 我们感谢 Guru Mani. Thank you, Guru Mani, for translation. Thank all the devotees for the questions. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Maharaj. 好，维昆的之音服务员聆听，非常感谢各位尊敬的 Vaishnava 的耐心的聆听和提出了这么多美好的问题。那我们下周二同一时间再见。Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Recording stopped.
Jai.